Presented by ChurchTechU, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to use Planning Center Live to display a timer on your stage screen. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. Before we get started, if you've ever wanted to have your timers automatically change based on which element you were in, then go ahead and click the like button below. See that? Yeah, doing that live. Anyway, so this is one of the things that we do at my church, and it just really frees us up to have everyone on the same page of how long an element is and how close we are to on time. Now, for some of you, that doesn't matter whatsoever. But for others of you, it matters a whole lot, especially if you've got multiple services and the time between services is like right on the edge of enough to swap out cars and such in the parking lot. So I thought that we'd go through how to do this in Planning Center Live and then show you what it takes to show it on ProPresenter on a stage screen. So let's head over to my computer and we'll take a look. So the first thing you need to do is make sure that you're signed into Planning Center Live. So let's go ahead and do that. We're gonna go to ProPresenter up here, then Preferences, and then Services. Think of services not as church services, but external services that ProPresenter can use. So we're gonna click on that. And you'll see that I've already logged into Planning Center Online. And so if you haven't, this is where you do it. Instead of log out, it would say log in. You type your name and password. Make sure that you have permission to do all this. Then these things don't really matter all that much. Just make sure that you're signed in. So that is step one. Step two is under View. You need to go down here to where it says Planning Center. And here that has popped up down here. It might be docked at the top. If it is and you want to move it around like that, click this button. So that's an important thing to know. Now, what you'll need to do is first, you'll need to have a plan that is running in Planning Center. A plan that you've created. It doesn't have to be running just yet. And you click the Change Plan button. Now, it could be that, here, let me go back, that you've got a login and password screen here. Just go ahead and log in again just to make sure that you're logged in right here and select the appropriate plan. So I've got a couple of plans here. And the one that I want is this one right here. So we're good to go there. I could, if I wanted to, kind of put this at the bottom, where I could advance it manually. At my church, we have a producer that does that. So I'm just going to close out on that. Now, the next thing that you want to do is you want to go to Screens and Edit Layouts to add the Planning Center countdown. So let's do that. And you'll see that I've already done one, but let me go ahead and I'm gonna delete that just to show you how to add that. So now we go to, I think it's under View and Planning Center right here. Oops, wrong one. Under Screens, Insert, yeah, Insert Planning Center Message, Planning Center Live, sorry. So you can do that, or you can click the plus button here and it is actually right there as well. So I'm just going to click that there. And that will bring this up here. And now I put it down here. Go back to show. And let's make sure that for my stage display, I'm going to make sure that I've got that particular layout selected. I already have. So I'm going to do that and let's preview it here. And you can't really see it all that well because it's red. But if we were to go over to my other screen, so here I can advance to the next item in the list, which is this song, and you'll notice that it's counting down right here. And now I can go back to this screen. And you'll see it right here. So there it is, counting down. And every time that you advance to a new item in the thing, you or a producer, someone is going to need to click the next button. As I say, you can do it here by just having this down here and just clicking this button down here, and that will do it. You can also go backwards, so on. So I'm actually just going through the different items in my Planning Center playlist. So that's how each of those resets. So I said automatic earlier. I was saying from the perspective of the ProPresenter operator, if a producer is doing it. If you want to have this on another screen, you can do that as well. You know, just drag that over to another screen if you've got another screen at the operator position, and do it that way as well. But either way, you can have this right here. Let me go ahead and show it to you full screen. Get rid of me. So there it is down here. This is what the stage display, stage screen layout would look like with this here. And that is how you would show your Planning Center countdown in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, I bet you'd like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to tdm.fyi/pro7quick. Go ahead, give me your name and email address so that I can make a login for you, and then you can take that course for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.